We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at La Muerta, Issue 1. This is part 1 of a 2-part miniseries called Retribution. They give you a brief little synopsis at the front, and it's about this woman that's got powers from the legendary La Llorona. I'm sure I pronounced that wrong. But effectively, she wears paint on her face to look like death, and she has like these kind of superpower type things for vengeance. Anyway, this is written by Mike Maclean, illustrated by Joel Gomez, colored by Ceci de la Cruz, lettered by Marshall Dillon, edited by Brian Polito, and the logo was designed by Jeff Moss. Now, if you like women being drawn like women, this may be for you. There is a sex scene, but it's mostly in shadow, so there's that. It is a very adult-oriented book. It's pretty violent and bloody. There's a lot of characters in here I don't know. I've never read any of this series before from the other miniseries, but it looks like Coffin Comics, who produces this, is just doing these as miniseries now instead of regular monthly series, which is fine. And since this is from 2018, I've had some time to track down other issues. I just haven't done it. So La Muerta is this girl named Maria. She's special friends with this male police officer, and they get abducted and absconded to this warehouse where these guys are, I think, trying to team up with her. Well, anyway, some bad guys have tracked her down, and there's three of them that are sort of supernatural type, and they go after her with some thugs, and there's a big shootout, and there's a ghost, and there's magic bullets. Things go south for her and her boyfriend pretty quickly. This was actually really, really fun. It's a $5 cover price, but I'm pretty sure you could find it cheaper than that. The art is okay. In my opinion, it's a little rough and needs some work on facial anatomy. This person can actually draw lips fairly well, which is usually the complaint I have with early art, but this artist, I think, is early enough in their career. They're not quite right with anatomy and positioning, so you'll see people standing at kind of weird angles with their arm in a weird position. Almost looks like they're using old G.I. Joe figures from the 80s as models to pose for the image. So I think there's a little bit of work that needs done on that. The cover is awesome though. That is a very nice cover. She looks really good. The scene looks very interesting, like something cool is going to happen. But it's a violent adventure ride that honestly would make kind of a cool movie. I think this character has a lot of potential and could be really, really fun. I'm intrigued enough to read the next issue and to maybe check out some older ones. I was never into the Lady Death universe back when they were at Harris or Chaos. I think it was Chaos Comics. So this might be a good intro to some of those characters. But if you get a chance to check it out, I'd recommend it. Is it worth $5? Probably not, unless you're into kind of cheesecake superheroes. But I was really surprised by how much plot there was to this and how much work actually went into it. I would say for story, it's actually a lot better than you'd expect. So if you get a chance to check it out, it's good superhero adventure stuff. If you like Punisher or things like that, this might appeal to you too. I'm gonna recommend this because I thought this was gonna be garbage, but it wasn't your stereotypical Mary Sue character that you get most of the time now with female characters. Instead, this was actually a well thought out character. There are consequences for the actions, and she does have concerns, doubts, and is put in danger, etc. Yeah, all in all, classic comic. I'm gonna recommend it. If you get a chance to check it out, I would definitely say do so. I don't know if it's worth the $5, so if you can find it for about $3, I think you'll be all right. I don't think I'd pay more than that for it, but it was definitely worth that much to me. I got the second issue. We'll look at that probably tomorrow, but in the meantime, this is a solid recommendation. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.